Dzisiaj moim gościem jest Tomasz Kelati, MVP Polskiej Ligi 2007, dwa razy wicemistrz Polski, mistrz Polski 2017, dwukrotny zwycięzca Pucharu ULEP 2010-2012, zwycięzca Ligi VTB. Wspaniała kariera, świetne kluby, zabrakło tylko tak naprawdę pełnego sezonu w NBA. Tomek, grałeś w Polsce, Hiszpanii, Rosji, Belgii. Rozumiesz cały czas, you understand, of course. Tell me in which language we will talk today.
Better in English.
I would like to speak in Polish, because muszę powiedzieć też kibicom, że tak ja po angielsku 2 lata w szkole średniej i 15 lat in locker room, 15 years in locker room.
Like me, I have 6 lat z domu, w Polsce
z córkami, tak?
tak.
No dobra, to so Pinglish, you know, you've heard about that.
Pinglish. Yeah. Polish English.
So we will try. Yeah. Okay, so first of all, there's a gift for you.
Oh, okay.
I have to tell you what is this. This is Ja Jordan Typista. I don't know if you heard about that. Coach Griszczuk, of course, you remember
him.
Oh,
yeah.
He was talking to American players in the locker room when he was mad. I'm Jordan, you pussy, and that's what that's what I have. This is a gift for you. And people, Polish fans, they are buying, Mr. Adam, they are buying this. How many we sell already?
I don't know.
Okay, doesn't matter. Okay, Thomas, when did your journey with basketball start?
Officially, I think around 8 or 9 years old. You know, I actually grew up playing football or soccer, as we call it in America. My dad was a soccer player, you know, coming from Africa. He was a coach. So I grew up
Position he played?
He was a midfielder, center mid. So kind of like me, I played that position. And also he was a long distance runner. So I grew up running long distance and playing soccer. But living in the United States, you know, basketball was a big sport. American football and baseball. Soccer was not so much. So, you know, in the school, kids were playing basketball. So I decided, you know, that's something I wanted to do too.
And that time you watched who? Michael Jordan, probably.
Of course. Michael Jordan was the man. Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen, the Bulls.
Just Chicago Bulls.
For the most part.
You were born in United States.
Yeah.
Your parents are from Eritrea?
Yeah.
Okay.
Good.
And which state you were born?
Washington State.
Walla Walla.
Walla Walla.
Tell me more about that city.
Small town. I don't know how my parents ended up way from the Horn of Africa in Eritrea, all the way to Walla Walla. It's a crazy story that one day maybe I can tell. But
you can tell now.
Okay. Well, you know, there was a war about to take place between Ethiopia and Eritrea. My dad was kind of like had some political play, you know, and was kind of against the Ethiopian government. So he decided it's better to kind of escape the country because he might have been targeted. So he ended up going to Saudi Arabia and found a job there. Had to sneak my mom out of the country 2 years later.
Sounds
crazy. I mean, all the way through Sudan, it was a treacherous, very difficult road. And the things that they went through, I remember at one point my dad said that as they were celebrating, they were in Yemen or somewhere around that area, and they were in a taxi, they were celebrating, the taxi driver was their friend, they're drinking a little bit, you know, to celebrate, and they came into a fork in the road. They didn't pay attention. One said Muslims this way, Christians this way. They went down the Muslim street. They came to a checkpoint, military checkpoint. And my father told me that, you know, he turned back to my mom, said, cover your face, don't say anything, because she didn't speak, Arabic. My dad did a little bit. Check guard or the military guys, they stopped the car and they asked, what are you guys doing? And luckily, the taxi driver had given them passport with quite a bit of money inside. And they didn't tell him, okay, hey, turn around, and don't come back this way or we won't be able to protect you, you know? So scary things like that. But he worked for the U.S. Corps of Engineers. He met a guy named Ernie, and Ernie was like, hey, land of, you know, come to America. It's a land of opportunity. Raise your family there. It's a great place. And this guy was from Walla Walla. So my dad ended up just, you know, meeting a stranger, becoming friends, and then listening to this guy to move his whole family, or to my wife, his wife, all the way to Walla Walla, Washington, which is, it's kind of a crazy story, but that's how we ended up in Walla Walla. And me and my sisters, we were all born.
Okay, there. When my guests are saying interesting stuff like that, I'm always say that there's a hashtag right now. I'm saying, dziękuję, że mi to powiedziałeś. Thank you for saying that.
Okay.
And tell me, who was your first coach when you were young? Before high school, or maybe you can say in high school.
You know, the most important coach I can say growing up was our high school coach, but I wasn't in high school yet. I was around 12 years old, and he threw these camps every summer. It was mm-hmm. called Thacker Camp. His name was Jim Thacker. He was a very well-renowned coach in that area, a great shooting coach. And, you know, from a young age, all we wanted to do, if you grew up in Walla Walla, was, hey, I want to get to Thacker Camp. It's called Thack Camp. And so when I was about 12 years old, I joined the camp for the first time. And, I mean, he took me aside. I think he saw potential in me. And he taught me the fundamentals of basketball. And really, everything that I am today, I really owe to him, because he taught me, you know, how to play the game the right way. And I mean, that just, it was so crucial for me going forward.
Okay, tell me, how many years you live in Poland?
Like officially live?
Yes.
Just, I would say like the last, you know, since I signed Zielona Góra, 2016, I came to Poland. I'm sorry, Turów. You know, it was my first experience, those 2 years in Turów. But then I bought a house in Zgorzelec in 2011, even though I was playing in Russia. So when we come back for the summers, you know, we'd come back here.
A couple of years.
Yeah, it's a couple of years.
I'm asking because I just want to know, what's the difference between United States and Poland when you think about playing Mr. Adam, learning kids playing basketball, yes? Correct?
Yeah.
Teaching.
I don't know much about the system here in Poland, but I know that in America it seems like you're taught, it's more of a street game, an individualized game. You know, I know that they have coaches and programs, but a lot of the basketball you grow up playing is done on the block, you know, like in the playground, at school, it's everywhere. People love to play. So you have to pick up these individuals. That's why you see a lot of American players. They're so good at one-on-one basketball.
Yes, that's,
I think that's the biggest difference. It's not always a good thing. You know, I'll be the first to tell you, but that's basically the root. I think the biggest difference between growing up in Europe.
In this modern basketball, that's what it is, one-on-one just right now.
Yeah.
I remember when I played and I grew up on Michael Jordan, we were, after the game, 6 in the morning, we're coming to play basketball. And right now, I think they are doing stuff. I don't know. They're starting. First of all, they want to play pick and roll, not to, you know, learn how to dribble.
Yeah.
Okay. So what I wanted to know. Next question is, where did you study and what?
So, I went to Washington State University. And the reason I chose that university is because I had about 16 offers in total from high school to college to come play. I chose that because it was about 2 hours from Walla Walla. So I knew that my family could see me. So I studied, I first went computer science. I loved computers. But then, you know, we have a guidance counselor in the university. She's like, Thomas, listen, you will have no life. You will go from practice to study. She's like, it's very difficult. So I listened to her and I decided to choose business. So I studied business management. Okay. At Washington State University. Yeah.
And tell me that the team in Washington State was good? When you think about the whole country.
I mean, it was in the best conference. You know, like it was in the Pac-10 conference. Okay. So we played against UCLA, Stanford, Arizona. I mean,
all the best.
It was probably the best conference in the
Did
in
you
US.
Play a lot? In the
yeah, that's why. That's actually probably the most important, I should tell you, why I went to that university. Because that was the only university of the 16 that offered me a chance to play my freshman year. I don't know if you know, but a lot of guys, when you go to college, if you're not ready, if they don't think you're ready to play, you can redshirt, mm-hmm. which means you get to sit out 1 year, you study, you practice, but it doesn't count because you're only allowed to play 4 years in college. So, but if you redshirt, it's like you get a fifth year.
Okay.
So I would have had to sit out and not play, but I didn't want to sit out. I wanted to play.
And you train a lot that time in college?
I mean, without a question, that was my biggest, you know, strength, because, you know, I wasn't always the most athletic. You know, there were guys bigger, stronger, faster than me, so I had to work. That's where I made it up for the lack, you know.
Who was coach in college?
First was Paul Graham. for the first 2 years, and they fired him, and they brought in like a legendary coach. His name is Dick Bennett. Maybe people know Tony Bennett was his son. He was the assistant coach. He's now the coach in Virginia. But yeah, Dick Bennett was, he was a legendary coach from Wisconsin that they brought over.
And I have to ask you about the NBA draft 2005.
Yeah.
Did you have any chances to go there?
Yeah. You know, my agent when at the time was like, hey, the Clippers, you know, I went to these draft workouts. I went to like 5 or 6 and did pretty well. But I think the most interest was from the Clippers. And they said, we might draft you in the second round between you and Daniel Ewing, who okay. also played in Poland.
Co-com.
But I mean, I knew that it wasn't going to be me because Daniel Ewing played at Duke. There was a connection. The coach was a Duke coach.
So connections are very important.
NBA.
And agents.
Oh man, it's very important. Very important.
So, and some of your colleagues went to NBA? Went from your team?
Oh yeah. Well, in our conference, it was like, you know, Brandon Roy, Nate Robinson, Josh Childress. Okay. I mean, there's... Most guys went to the NBA.
Okay, after Washington State, you moved to Europe, to yep. Belgium. You signed with Dexia Mons, High Note.
Yeah.
Who was coach there? Igor, and who was the coach? And Igor Milicic was there playing?
Yeah, Nikša Bavsević was Croatian coach. And mm-hmm. Igor Milicic was actually
point guard,
the point guard, yeah, on that team.
And that was your first season overseas.
Yeah.
It was hard to...
It's terrible.
Tell me what was terrible.
This is my first experience with, let's say, a Balkan coach. These guys okay. were crazy at that time. I didn't know what I... And also, I was a little bit arrogant. I was like, coming from the NBA, you know, I was with the Clippers. I chose to come to Europe instead of staying with them. So I was like, I was pretty confident, you know, kind of arrogant. And came over there and this guy just had me running stairs, running around, was yelling at me, calling me kurats and stuff like this. What's this guy calling me kurats?
Panie, what does it mean? Pan Adam kurats przetłumaczy, co to jest kurats.
Yeah, this is... Yeah. So anyways, this guy was...
Oh my God.
Yeah, you know, crazy. And I was like, man, and then he would play me, then he wouldn't play me. And I was wondering, I asked the veteran player, what's going on? Why is this guy not like me? He's like, oh, this is what they do. They tried to, you're a rookie, so they break you down and then they build you back up. And let's just say I remember had many, many phone calls with my mom saying, hey, you know what? I'll just come back to the U.S. and I'll work. I almost gave up on basketball.
Really?
That experience. I was like, I'll just go to the U.S.
But
and work.
Why you choose Belgium after almost being Clippers, you signed with the
you
Belgium
know,
team?
I didn't know anything about Europe. For me, the same, Belgium was the same as Spain. I didn't know anything. You know, Americans, we're, you know, we're kind of, we only know about America, let's just say, okay. you know? And so I had a Spanish agent call me, a guy called me and he said, hey, I'll take you to Spain. I was like, I told him, Spain, I'm going to the NBA. So no, thank you.
But when we go through this conversation, you played in great clubs. So yeah, Belgium was a bad start, yeah, but after that, you will say more. So let's finish this Belgium yeah. stuff. What will be interesting for Polish fans, Turów Zgorzelec. You sign after Belgium 2 years deal or 1+1?
One deal, 1 year deal.
With Turów Zgorzelec.
Yeah, yeah. And it's important to say, Igor Milicic, I think, is the one that got, I heard that he's the one that called or talked to Sasho Filipowski.
Okay.
And he had said, hey, this kid can play, take him. And that's why Sasho brought me to Turów.
Okay. And that was the first time I heard about you. Tell me your first impression about Poland.
We landed in an airport in Wrocław, which was not this nice one.
I know.
This old thing. There was no highway, so some guy picked me up who didn't speak English. In some
cool, you remember?
Man, I can't remember.
Not Grzesiek.
But it was no. He was like, Kilati, Kilati. When I came out the airport, I was like, okay, and I was ready. Like
where, Szaka, Mr. Szaka.
Someone. So, and we took this van. We went on this like 3-hour drive because it was all these back roads. So I got to see this beautiful countryside going through these back roads and just thinking like, where am I going? Where am I? You know, this is a different world compared to, you know, what I was used to. So,
but in summer, that was the summer. So,
yeah, like August. Yeah. So
it was nice. But right now it's not nice.
Yeah.
First impression would be, and you?
I was like, I didn't care. I came to play basketball, so I had that mindset and also to be open-minded. So it was different. It was, Zgorzelec was not what it is today. I'll tell you, it was, the only thing I recognized was one McDonald's that was in Zgorzelec. And
so that's good information.
not the best diet for a basketball player, okay. but yeah.
But still a piece of America
yeah,
in Zgorzelec.
Exactly.
But probably it was tough because you told me right now you almost finished your basketball career after one season in Belgium and you came to Lille Zgorzelec. It was not,
you know,
easy.
It wasn't, but it was.
I'm just thinking, what have you in
mind? It was the best thing that, I mean, yeah, I couldn't have foreseen that, but for me, it was just like.
Just basketball.
Yeah, it was a chance. Like my agent did a good job. He sold it. My agent was like, "Hey, this coach, he's great."
Can you tell the name of your agent?
At that time, he was an American. His name was Dave Maravilla.
Okay.
And he knew Sasha, and he said, "Hey, this guy's a coach. It doesn't matter where you're going. He will make you a player. He will let you play. He will give you minutes." So I said, "Okay, I'll give it another shot."
I will ask you about later about Coach Filipowski. Yeah. Tell me your favorite Polish food.
Oh man, this is hard to say. There's so many.
A teraz po polsku mów.
Ja lubię wszystko.
No to co lubisz? Na śniadanie co lubisz?
Na śniadanie jest kiełbasa, wszystko.
No, jajka, dobra. Obiad?
Zupa jest. Jaka? Ja lubię zupę. Pomidorowe, biały barszcz.
Super.
Czerwony barszcz.
Tak?
Flachy.
Flachę lubisz? Flachę? You said battle. Flachę z wodką.
Piwo?
To jest dobre, nie?
I tell you, my wife, her mother spoils me. She's a cook and she, so I get...
Everything. A pierogi?
A pierogi, unbelievable.
So especially Christmas and...
That's what I love. I love the... Easter. Like, all the holidays. Christmas, Easter. I love food, man.
Dobrze. You told me, who wanted you in Zgorzelec, so you told me Coach Filipowski wanted you the most.
Yes, yeah.
How you remember that season, 2006-2007? You won MVP title, almost 16 points per game, almost 3 made points, 44% for 3 points. Almost the same stats next season. What do you remember about that season?
I remember it didn't start good. And I actually think that I heard later that they wanted to fire me and Turov because the first two games, I think was we played Anvil, which is a good Anvil, and Shlonsk. And we lost on our home court, one away. I didn't play that good. So I think there was rumors, getting ready to, this guy's not, for this. But I think Sasha kind of talked with them and mm-hmm. he saw what I could do in practice. So there was one game I had, it was kind of the turnaround for me. I think it was a third or fourth game where I scored 14 points and I finally, let's say, found my rhythm. And from that point on, just went up. And
you qualified the Polish league. Next season you played in ULEP Cup, this final eight. So let's talk about this first Polish final against strong ASECO team.
Yeah.
What do you remember about that?
I remember that there was no way they were going to let us win against a EuroLeague powerhouse. No, I can't say that. That's not fair, but they were a great team. I mean, they had great players, experienced players.
Danny Ewing that time? Was there?
No, I never won those first 2 years.
Okay.
Second place. We lost in the final, but I mean, it was a great experience and that team was just, they were too good.
Możesz to zdjęcie włączyć? I have to...
I know.
In your first final, that happened or second?
I hate this picture too.
No, tell me about that.
Hey, listen, we need to give an award for whoever took that picture because I honestly...
Tak właśnie, muszę powiedzieć, award for Wojciech Figurski.
Yeah, tutaj, because... I remember this like it was yesterday. When I saw this picture, I don't even remember him hitting me in my... It looks like he's poking my eye out.
Looks terrible.
But this happened so quick. But all I remember too about this is you see, I don't know, whoever this referee is, I wasn't really doing it. I was the one that got attacked. The referee ran over and he hugs me. So my mm-hmm. arm, and I just see Gurevich coming at me. I'm like, oh my. So I was
strong referee.
Yeah, he was holding me, and so he, I had my left arm up, able to kind of shield off, but he didn't even swing. It's a terrible picture. He looks like he's about to murder me. But I said, that happened. Whoever took that picture was in the exact moment. I mean, it had to be in that second. So,
but I read an interview with you, and you said you are a normal guy, calm guy, and he provoked you. Yeah, yeah. And he said that you provoked him. Yes.
Yeah, he said. He had. I mean, I think that I know what really happened. He had to say that because how are you going to explain that? What happened was I scored, I think, 11 straight points on him, and he was frustrated, and he just from what I heard, you know, Dragiša Drobnjak.
Drobnjak, yes.
He told me later, because they asked him, he said, what happened? And he said, he's like, I want to. He told them, he's like, I just want to go home.
So he said, was frustrated.
He was just frustrated. He said he just wanted to go home. He just wanted to end this playoff. But I don't know. I listen, for me as a player, I think most players can agree. I don't talk trash on the court. So I'm not the guy that, like, I'm not a provoker.
I know you. I don't know if you agree, but I think a couple years ago, I don't know, that was a 2007.
Yeah.
I think that there was more dirty basketball. And yeah. You know what? I want to apologize to you because you were that good player, and you know, I played in Schloss, young player. They were saying, yeah, not destroy Thomas, but you know, do everything. And we were trying to as a young kids. I'm sorry that I could do something better, and never, jak to powiedzieć? Nic specjalnego, nothing on purpose. Yes. That's what I want to tell you.
No worries, man. Yeah,
but you were that good that, you know, we can do anything. You're running around screens, through screens, everything.
Yeah.
Okay, Mr. Adam, wyłącz to. I will ask you right now, because you, when you were close to beat second year, you were close to beat them. It was 3-3.
It was that year. It was 3-3, and we had the last game on our home court in Skorzelec, and actually he went crazy. Gurevich had an incredible game
because
he was suspended the day before or the game before.
Okay,
and he came back, and I mean, really, you got to give credit because that's the type of player
that was your
he
matchup,
was.
Yes, him,
who, and me who? And yeah, he yeah me and Vjeko Petrovic. But okay. I mean, we relaxed a little bit. We thought for sure. We were already thinking about the championship in our home court because they couldn't beat. We beat them by 30 the last time, like game two or something like that. So we're like, okay, we got this. And he went crazy. And that's, I mean, you got to give him credit. He's a good player.
Okay, I have to ask you about coach Sasha Filipowski. Mm-hmm. What kind of person he is in your opinion, as a man and as a coach?
Can't find a better person. He's a great, great person. I'm talking about off the court, incredible. Somebody you can talk to, who cares about his players, physically and mentally, will help you at any time. You know, when I was going to sign Jalen Gore, I actually called him to ask him because he was there the year before. But great guy, family guy. I know he had some problems here in Poland, but I mean, you know, you can't fault him. Sometimes he's human, you know, and emotions get the best of us. So,
and as a coach,
smart, very smart, very hard, but again with this Balkan coaches, this mentality, but it worked. I was young then. I was 20, you know, 24 years old, so I could do it. But I was
with him 1 year in Zielona Góra, and I played, I don't know, 15 minutes, and I was, you know, happy because he told me what he wanted from me, and I never heard something bad from other players that about him.
No,
nothing. Just, even if they didn't play.
Yeah, he was exactly. That's, I think that every single player that played for Sasha on that team, whether you play 5 minutes or 20, respect.
I don't remember that. Yeah. Tutaj co my tu mamy? Dobra, I asked about the coach Filipowski. What advices you can give for young American players coming like straight from school to Europe?
I would say the faster you adapt to the culture of the country you're playing in and come here with an open mind, don't think it's going to be like America. Don't bring whatever you were in America, don't bring that same attitude or that same mentality over here. You know, you try to go out and experience some of the culture. I think that's the best way. Once you get a better feeling for the people in Poland or in Spain, wherever you play, it definitely is better for you. Because I think that players come over here and they isolate themselves. They don't interact with the people, the local people. I'm saying, okay, in the team, yes, but outside, go out and experience it. When are you ever going to be in Europe? It's such a blessing to come out here and to experience it. So, you know, be open-minded and try to adjust as fast as you can.
But in Poland, when you played in Zgorzelec, your teammates helped you?
Yeah. You know, well, yeah, I had guys like, let's see, like, well, Koszarek was there. He didn't speak English that much, but he's much better now. Even guys like Edek Jacques, who was there. So, you know, they helped me. And even Piotr
Pluta, brother of Andrzej.
Yes, you know, the guys like that. And then also it was great to have my Serbian brothers too. They help me out, you know.
Dragiša. Okay, I have to ask you about this ULEP Cup final against Dynamo Moskva. There was a chance to beat them.
There was. We played pretty good, but I mean, again, they were just too. They were too deep. You know, they had some really good. Henry Dolmerkamp was an incredible player, man. I think he went 6 for 6 from three. But we just were, you know, we weren't as deep as them, and they played a better second half.
Dobra, jedziemy dalej. Great 2 years in Poland, and then you sign in Spain, Unicaja Málaga. Who was coach there?
Aito. Coach Aito Renesis Garcia, something like that.
Garcia, listen, yes. You remember Aito. Names of the players?
Yeah, for the most part, yeah.
So yeah. You can say famous, like people, fans that will know.
Well, I mean, Omar Cook was my point guard.
Team.
Yeah, Omar Cook, Boniface Endong played in the NBA. Marcus Hayslip was also played in the NBA. Unfortunately, Robert Archibald, who I don't know if you know, he just passed away. Yeah, he was 39 years old. We still don't know the reason why he passed, even in the U.S., but he was also on that team. So yeah, man. And then a lot of good Spanish
players. And that was your first time in EuroLeague that time?
Yeah, first EuroLeague experience, yeah.
Tell me, I have to ask you about Spanish League, about the level of the Spanish League. Is the best way?
Yeah, that especially back then, top to
what's
bottom.
What's the characteristic for this league?
I mean,
how they play.
You know what they did? The Spanish players were good, but at that time, I think it was everyone knew it was the best league. They paid the best. It's the most organized. Every game was on TV. So all the best players, you know, when you hear, hey, I want to get to Spain. When you're playing in Europe, I want to get to Spain. That's how I found out about Spain. So, I mean, top to bottom, it was the best league. I mean, the number 16 team or 17, whatever they were, if you didn't prepare, if you didn't come focused, they could beat you. So
I remember when I play against Spanish teams, for me, of course, I'm not fast. I'm always saying I suppose not to play basketball, but with my, jak to się mówi, parametry, with my body.
Cool. Yeah,
but I have good shot.
That
doesn't matter. I remember they play really fast. Fast all the time. They're running.
That's one thing I had to learn. And that's one thing that I had to tell. So crazy story about him was, you know, we had this like, was this 3-on-2 continuous fast break, and I would get like a breakaway lay-in, and he would like, Thomas, just stop and pull the three. I said, well, I have a guaranteed 2 points. No, shoot a three. It's the first coach ever told me that. So actually, that's why I shot the most. I shot in one game 19.
You tied the,
oh my goodness.
Still is tied the record? The EuroLeague
for most shots? No, it's not. Somebody beat it. Somebody beat it. Made 10. I made 9, but I shot 19 threes. But anyways.
And you step on the line. You're supposed to be.
Yeah, that was. Yeah, yeah.
What do you have achieved in this team? You as a team? Yes.
Yeah. As a player.
As a player, as a team.
In Málaga?
Yes.
I mean, I grew a lot because that was the first time I played with those type of players, that caliber of players. These guys were coming from the NBA and playing that. Even the Spanish veteran players, I mean, the experience, I couldn't figure it out because I knew that, like, there's like Bernie Rodriguez, one player, for example. I was better than him in every way, you know, physically, mentally, everything, you know, and he would kill me every day in practice. I couldn't figure it out. He's just so smart and so experienced. And so it really took my level of play. I understood, wow, there's so much I had to learn. It's not just about, you know, shooting or how fast you can cross somebody over. It's the IQ and understanding how the game, how the positioning angles. So it really, I think grew into a more diversified player.
So you were in shock after 2 years in Poland coming to Spain everything. Okay, 2009, and we will talk about Los Angeles Lakers, Kobe Bryant, what is now important for everybody.
Yeah.
You signed a not guaranteed contract?
Right.
What is the story? Tell me about this.
Yeah, so first I signed with Olympiacos after EuroLeague. So it was a big deal, my biggest deal, and then I went over there, flew over there, did a medical physical. They said, oh no, you have a problem with your, like, in my abdomen. They said, you need surgery immediately. I said, I feel healthy. I feel fine. That's okay. So I went back home to the US. They signed a guy named Von Wafer from the NBA, and they said, okay, we're thinking about keeping you because the surgery is only 4 weeks. But then at the end.
So they fucked you a bit?
Yeah, they did.
Przetłumaczysz, to brzydko powiedziałem. Brzydkie słowa, yeah. Kamil.
And at the end they said, okay, we know we don't want you. So I ended up talking to my agent. I was running in the US, so I was like, I don't want to go back to Europe right now. So he found me a couple of tryouts with different teams. And I had a tryout with the Lakers and I think San Antonio, Cleveland, and they all three offered me to come to camp, but I chose to go to the Lakers.
But through Summer League, you signed there?
No, I didn't play. It was like just a workout. They brought me and another player.
Pre-season,
there.
Yes. Yeah,
like this was it was like a private workout.
Okay.
To see if I could play, and then they came to me and said, "Okay, we think we like you. You know,
who was there? Coach Phil Jackson was on this workout.
No, not this workout. It was then when I started when they accepted me as coming to training camp and to try to make the team. Mm-hmm. That's when I met with the everybody. The whole.
And your emotions, you were in stress when you think about NBA.
Hell yeah, man! I would that was my problem. That's my biggest problem is that when I come to Europe, I'm confident I play, but as soon as I get to these NBA workouts, I already start doubting myself. Oh, these guys are, you know, it's Kobe Bryant. I'm going to be playing against the best in the world. So already I'm putting myself at a disadvantage because I think that physically I cannot be with these guys. So yeah, it was a lot of stress.
You said about Kobe Bryant, you met him there. We all know what happened to him and his family. All players who knew him were saying they are devastated. Tell me more about him. About Coach Filipowski as a man, as a player.
So from before that point, what I heard about Kobe Bryant was just what I saw, what I read, other people. And you hear the same thing. He works hard. He's intense. He's competitive. And then, you know, when I get there, his first day of camp, I'm like, you know, of course, I'm like nobody to him, but I'm like, just, oh, that's Kobe Bryant. You know, I'm like starstruck a little bit. And just an incredible, incredible person. He was so, I think just, I've never seen somebody so in tune, so focused on whatever he was doing. So we were there from the first day, they just won a championship the year before. It's the first day of training camp. So I'm thinking it's gonna be relaxed. No, he was so intense. From the very beginning, he kind of gave a speech. Hey, you guys are all here, you rookies.
He started with a speech.
Yeah, he told
before the coach.
Phil Jackson kind of, there's all the welcomings, all this stuff. But he, you know, he told everyone, hey, you know, listen, we just came off a championship year. No, relax. You had your summer vacation. Let's get to work. And it was like, wow, from the first day. So, and then as I got to know him more, he's just a good guy, man. You know, off the court, it's like everyone says, you wouldn't even know. He's so considerate and loving, and he's a great dad. He's a good husband. He cares about people, so, which I didn't know. I thought he was, you know, kind of, they said he's kind of a, you know, he's an asshole. He's mean or something like that, but
I didn't know that.
No.
I thought he was like that.
Yeah, me too, right? And even for me, like, he didn't treat me like a rookie. I was a rookie, but he was like, hey, you're here, you're in a Lakers jersey, and he would help me. When he saw me, hey, this is what you need to do, this, like that. And so it was really, I was taken
so
away.
So he came by himself to you to say something, not like,
yeah,
you trying to
actually, do you have time? Okay. This is I wish because we know it's enclosed, so there's no, I wish there was like a video of this, but so every day at the end of practice, we play 5-on-5, you know, and they'd bring in three referees. So we'd play. And I had an incredible game against him. I was playing defense. I think I stole the ball from him one time, was physical with him, scored a few points on him. So it was really good. I was really impressed with the way I played. The next morning, you know, my agent said, hey, make sure that you're always there 1 hour before practice shooting, you know, trying to make the team, make it look good for the coaches.
Yeah, see Kobe.
I get in the gym and there's a few other guys there. Like Paul Gasol's there, Derek Fisher was there, Shannon Brown, Tony Gaffney, the other rookie.
Great company.
Yeah. So, and I'm just shooting by myself, and out of nowhere, Kobe just walks over to me. He called me They called me Wally because Walla Walla.
Walla Walla.
Like he was like, where the fuck is Walla Walla? Like that's what they all said, you know. So they called me Wally.
You show him where he can come to me.
He didn't care.
It's
trust me. Yeah. So Wally, what's up, man? And he's like, he's like, Wally, come on. He just tossed me the ball. And he gets in position on defense on the post. So I'm like, playing 1-on-1 against Kobe, okay, in the post. I'm not a post player, but I was like, okay, what do you say no to this guy? So it's before
practice.
No, I'm not
playing Kobe, no.
So, you know, I just is like, okay, my typical go-to, I did a turnaround fadeaway. I made it. okay, 1-0.
Left hand?
Step. You know, right? I was on the right block. So okay, like kind of this, right, turn around over my left, okay, over my right shoulder shot. Next one, kind of pump fake play, then step back, just one dribble, quick step back, jumper. All jumpers, you know me, I'm not physical. And out of the corner, you know, these guys like Lamar Odom and them, like, oh, get him, Rook, you know,
yeah,
get him, Rook, get him, Wally. And he just looked over like, yeah, right. So he gives me the ball. Mm. So I try to go, I kind of make contact. I want to do a turnaround fadeaway again. He slaps my arm so hard, ball just goes up.
No foul.
I can't call a foul on him.
Of course.
He takes the ball. Okay. I'm like, all right, my turn to play defense. Hey, like so easily, just boom, right hook, left hook, turnaround, pump, 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 basket. 5-2. He scores. We go to the next block, 5-0. And I've never felt so helpless in that moment. I mean, I'm sweating. He was just casual. For him, it was nothing. He was so strong.
He said he trash talked you that time?
No, he didn't need to.
No,
that time. Nothing. But that's one thing. There's so much. That's one thing. If I tell the fans or people in the NBA, I think Marcin Gortat can confirm this. There is so much trash talking. I couldn't believe it. I was looking at Coach Phil Jackson like, are you serious? Like from the day one, the things that they say, like if there was a microphone there, you would, you know, like it'd be banned from TV because of how much trash talking, the things that, but that's part of the game over there. So, but yeah, he never talked trash to me. He just showed me how dominant he was and he didn't even sweat. And I thought I was playing good defense, but.
When you talk about him, I see Michael Jordan. He was doing probably the same thing, same competitive.
Oh, for sure. I mean, those guys, they're on a different level.
He grew up, though.
Different level.
Grew up on him. Yeah. On him. Yeah. Playing. You have more stories about you, Kobe?
I mean, no, that was basically, that was.
But tell me how the practices looks like in the preseason in the NBA.
Yeah, they were.
When you can compare us to Europe, I don't know, Poland.
Yeah, they're not. Europe is intense. Europe, you come here and you work.
You
run stairs in the mountains, the rivers.
They call you Kuras.
Cool. 3 hours tape practice in the morning, 3 hours at night. You know, in the NBA, it's good because they protect it. There's only one. You're only allowed, I think, one or two a days in the whole preseason. But we in LA, we practice at 11, from 11 to like 1:30. One practice a day.
Okay.
That's it. So, yeah. It wasn't nothing intense, nothing too bad.
I have to ask you about one-on-one. You told me about Coach Phil Jackson. Tell me about him.
Phil Jackson, man. So
that's like our Coach Filipowski.
Yeah. Coach Phil Jackson's so we get there and, you know, he gave his little bit. He talked to us a little bit, very little, but he always, first of all, in the NBA, there's like 15 coaches, staff. I don't know. There's more staff than there is players, but. You know, he was going through a hip problem. So they had this big, really comfortable chair that they would stick on the sideline and he would sit and watch. He would just sit and watch. And the coach, the practice was ran by the other coaches. They would, you know, run practice. But when he would see something he didn't like, we know he ran that triangle offense. He would do his.
Still, he was doing the same thing.
Yeah, but he would, his same triangle offense, and he would see something that didn't work or that he didn't like. And he would stand up, and I'm telling you, every single player just stop. And you have to, I mean, so much respect was given him. And he'd come over, never yelled, very calm, was like, hey guys, look, no, if you want it to work right, you have to, you know, you have to move here. And this has this, and he would explain it. He'd go back and sit down, and then we'd play again. But a lot of respect for him.
5 days before start of the season, the Lakers waived you. How you felt? Who told you about this?
So they called me. I had a feeling it was coming, you know. So what
sounds
they did,
like you are pretty sure you stay with them.
I mean, I was sure I was going to stay because my agent called me and said that, hey, my guy who brought me there, they had a meeting, a staff meeting, and Phil Jackson in the meeting said, hey, Kobe likes the Karate Kid. That's what, so he's like, whatever you're doing it, you know, my agent, you're doing good. So I was like, okay, cool. But then, like you said, 5 days before the last game, or there's two, I think there's two preseason games left. If I would have played those two preseasons, my contract is guaranteed no matter what. Okay. So they brought me in with the GM, Mitch Kupchak, and Phil Jackson. And we had about a 20-minute conversation, and they told me a lot of good things about myself. And they basically said that I was not on the team because of a luxury tax.
Okay.
they spent too much money on other players, so they would have to pay double for me, which didn't make sense for them because I was just gonna be a.
When I hear that, I'm sad a little bit, you know.
You, I was crying because they won a championship that year. I know the last championship, and I was just
ring, yeah, NBA ring.
But they offered me. They said, "Look, Phil Jackson said straight up. He said, "Hey, we'll put you on the D League team." And we'll probably, you know, I'm sure we'll call you up throughout the year. And I said, well, I want to go to Europe and play.
You were how old you were at that time?
Oh, man, 2009 was it 27 maybe? Yeah, something like that, 27? Yeah.
Yeah, but that was the time to make money, not to. Yeah, well, that's why you decided
to play, you know.
After that, you signed with Valencia.
Yeah.
Back again in Spain. 2010, you won ULEP Cup.
Yeah.
What season? What kind of season that was for you?
Amazing. That's probably the most memorable season because of the group of guys that I play with.
Who?
1 through 12. We had Rafa Martinez, Matt Nielsen. There was who is it? Florin Piet, yeah, Pietrus. I said him. Yeah, you know him. Who else was there? I'm gonna get with all the names.
Mr. Adam will put on.
Yeah, I mean they. Because I keep wanting to say Perasovic, but that's the coach. That was a coach. It was
from Balkan Perovic. Coach.
Yeah, he was This was Spahia. Name Spahia. But anyway, I mean, 1 through 12, like we did everything together. That was the first time I had a team like that where we were like a fan. Like we'd go out to dinner with each other. We'd go to movies with each other. We when we go out on the road, we would go out together. It was
the best season.
Yeah, it was incredible. Yeah.
I have to ask you about Polish national team.
Yeah.
I know why you have Polish passport, but maybe tell the fans again how this happened.
Mój żona jest Polak.
No to teraz po polsku, Tomek. Mów troszkę po polsku.
No, yeah, I got it through. I mean, me and my wife, we got married, and I wasn't even thinking about, I didn't know about how the nationalities worked and all that I wouldn't be considered American. I was just, you know, I loved my wife, we married, and then I got approached by, I can't remember who, but someone's like, hey, you know.
I think Grzegorz Schetyna.
Yeah, and said, you know, hey, we can maybe you want to play on the national team. I was like, hey, absolutely. That's amazing to be able to represent a country. And in my head, I was just thinking I would love to play in the Olympics with Poland. If I can get to an Olympics, that was my whole
dream.
My dream, you know. So.
You remember your debut in a Polish national team?
Oof, it was with the first year because it wasn't
Bulgaria.
We didn't play a European championship. It was with the, what's his name of the coach?
Grischuk.
Yeah. This is okay.
I'm Jordan Jupusi. That sounds funny in English.
Yeah, no, this is good. I'm Jordan in Europe. Yeah,
because I always respected him. I don't want to have, you know, fun because of that. But literally, you were sitting in a locker room, and he didn't speak English.
No,
and he was so pissed. He said, I'm Jordan, you pussy.
Yeah.
For us, we were dying laughing, man. We were dying laughing.
I think it's better that he didn't, I didn't understand him too much. Because he was intense.
He didn't say this to you.
Not to me, I know, but
in Iraq.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Oh.
Drew Joyce was that.
Yeah,
time.
Yeah.
He
yeah.
will know that. Oh, my God. You know Drew Joyce, he's a friend of, remember him? Yeah. I don't know, you didn't play there. He's a good friend of LeBron James.
Oh, really? Who's it?
Drew Joyce.
True choice. Oh, okay. Yeah, I didn't play against it. No.
But anyway, you remember your coaches in Polish team?
Yeah.
Grischuk,
yeah.
Bauerman.
And from Slovenia, Pippen. Yeah.
Your best memories with the.
I mean, I just loved the experience. It was great to be able to represent something bigger than yourself, you know, to not play with the name on your back but play for a country is, I had a lot of pride. Poland meant something to me, and to play for the Polish national team, I took it very serious. So that was probably the best experience. But that 2000, where is it when we went to Slovenia? We had such an incredible team. If you looked at the roster of that team.
I spoke to Michał Ignerski, who was here, and it was a great team.
Iggy's great. He'll tell you more, probably, but it was, we just fell apart
first
when we got
probably,
to the tournament. Because before, we were killing everybody. We were destroying.
What happened? In
my opinion, I don't know if I want to go into detail because I don't want to make anybody mad, but I felt like everything was fine in preseason. And then when we got to, you know, to the tournament, we just, everybody kind of did some, not everybody, you know, we went away from what we were doing, what was successful for us. And we, I think we had guys that wanted to show something on that level. And instead of, you know, relying on the team and playing how we were supposed to. Yeah, I don't want to
get, okay,
get too much.
But I know what you are talking
you
about.
You know.
Okay, let's finish this. 2010-2012, after Valencia, you signed in Russia.
Yeah.
You won the Euro Cup back again, VTB League.
Yeah.
Yeah. How they celebrate in Russia?
lots of vodka. Yes. Lots of vodka. I remember the flight from the VTB. We beat CSKA, and to beat CSKA in a championship was like, I mean, you're everything. Yeah. So yeah, we were flying back. We had a charter, a private plane. I remember they had their, it was three levels of the plane. They had the management, they had the players, and even the cheerleaders were in the back. And along with the, and I remember it kind of scared me too, because I realized at one point, they're passing, was it this Johnny Walker, the Black Label, right? The Black or Blue, whatever is the most expensive one. They were passing around drinking, and at one point, from the bottle. But there were a lot of bottles. And me and I was Crescia Launcher, I was sitting there, and then we were talking and enjoying. And then all of a sudden, I see the pilot come out.
No,
and I'm like, and he's enjoying himself too. I'm like, wait. It's like this. Pilot
was drinking flacha from the tent.
Well, I mean, I don't want to get anyone, you know, again, but
nobody knows
him. Yeah, so I was like,
Who
knows?
Was drunk already.
Who knows? So like this. I was like, you know, I just said a prayer. I said, please just let me get home safe. You know, what can you do? You know, everybody's having a good time. And, but yeah, that was so Russia was crazy.
Yeah.
Crazy for me.
Russia or Spain? When we are talking about, I don't know, living.
Spain. Spain, safe family. Russia, just, you never know.
I just wanted to ask. Maybe you like Russia more. 2012-2013, znowu Valencia.
Yeah.
And after Valencia, you signed. I speak right now a little bit Polish and English. 2013, Baskonia, the same season.
Yeah.
Why?
Well, no, I. Wait, how did it go? I finished with Valencia and then in the summer, a normal contract that whole year.
Yeah.
And then I went to Baskonia because I got an offer from Gran Canaria and a couple others, but I didn't like the offers. Mm-hmm. Even Jelena Gore actually offered me and I said no. And then I was going to go to the United States. Actually, I was on my way to the US when I got a call from my agent, said, hey, somebody got injured. Adam Hanga got injured in Baskonia. They need somebody to replace him for 2 months. So I went there for two months.
2014-16 Murcia.
Yeah.
Your memories from there, from Murcia, from Baskonia. I don't know, maybe you have some funny stories, good stories.
From Baskonia, not so much. I didn't really like it there. It was cold, but Murcia is incredible, man. Murcia is a great, if anybody wants to go, any player that's kind of winding down their career or get a chance to play in Murcia, it's a great place to play. Really, really great city because it's not expensive like, let's say, Valencia or Malaga. You're still close to the water and they treat you really well there.
You told me about your best season. That was in the first season in Valencia. That was your best season and then toughest season.
The toughest season.
Till that time.
I mean, for sure, it had to be my first year in Belgium.
Belgium.
That experience, the whole, I mean, from start to finish, it was, even though I won co-MVP of the Polish, of the Belgian Cup, and we won the championship, mm-hmm. That was a highlight of that year. It was just a terrible year for me.
I'm not asking about how much money you made, mm-hmm. but where you have the biggest contract?
Kimki in Russia, yeah. They don't know how to negotiate in Russia.
They just give money, yes?
No, I had offer from Real Madrid, and believe it or not, Olympiacos offered me again after that. I sued them and whatever from the previous, but they offered me again. And then Kimki said, no, we'll take him for this.
A lot, a lot of my guests, I don't know, Coach Uvalin was here. Players, they played in Ukraine.
Yeah.
They said the money comes in the bag. That's okay.
Yeah.
So you confirmed that.
Yeah.
That's a lot of money.
Yeah. I'll tell you.
A lot of money in the bag.
I will tell you about my I can tell you about one instance. So we won the VTB championship. So I was telling you, we flew back Two days later, with the drunk pilot, we made it safely. So 2 days later, the boss came in and he said, "Okay, guys, congratulations. We told you team bonus because none of you didn't have the bonus in your contracts." He kicked out the staff and everybody. It was just the players. I can say this. I hope he brought in like fresh minted $100 bills, like $300,000 stack in a plastic paper. He said, "Here." He put on this to the captain, Vitaly Fridzone, and said, "Divide it amongst yourselves." So we, you know, we were being stupid. You know, we're taking pictures, and then we actually took 3,000 each, yeah. And we decided to give to the doctors and to the.
That's nice. So that's very good.
That was So I know they were happy with that, but it was.
So, miałeś takiego kiedyś szefa, co tyle pieniędzy przyniósł? And divide on everybody. Dobra, I ask you about the biggest contract. The best coach you have is?
I would say
it's
Sasha.
Sasha, okay.
Sasha Filipowski.
Worst? You want to say?
I mean, I don't want to say he was like a bad coach. Yeah, but it was, let's say, worst experience, you know, that I went through.
The most important trophy for you.
Most important trophy. That's a tough.
Takie moje trudne pytania trochę, no ale.
Yeah,
musisz odpowiedzieć.
I mean, they're also. I mean, it's a rare, you know, because I know players who have gone their whole career and never won.
Yeah.
So each win is means a lot. But I think that also the one in Zielonogora was meant something to me because, I mean, it was like I was coming there. There was some rumors, you know, I'm hearing things like, "Oh, this guy's old, or he's got a bad knee." Artur Gronik, you know, he's a young. He can't, you know, he can't control this type of talent. So there was a lot of like, let's say, noise that was coming from outside of that was influencing. And so to win it, the Polish Cup and the championship,
it was not easy.
Yeah. And then to come back because I lost two finals in Poland. So to now finally say I won a championship, it kind of completed my Polish tour.
Hashtag thank you for saying that. Dzięki, że mi to powiedziałeś. Which season gave you the most? You told me about this season in Malaga, yes?
Valencia. Well, no, Malaga, where I learned a lot. You're right. But the most, I would say that my first year in Turov with Sasha, those because he put me back on. You know, I wasn't too thrilled with basketball. I was contemplating maybe not even playing anymore. Mm-hmm. So coming to Turov, it kind of like gave me a second chance. And from that point on, my career kind of went up and blossomed. So that was probably the most impactful, let's say, in my career.
So we can say that was a good city team that you could focus just on the basketball.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Where were the best fans? I'm not talking about clubs, but...
Yeah.
Country. It's different probably.
I'm trying to think. So Russia, the fans are kind of like calm and quiet. You know, the games, you know, even in Spain, people come there with their families. So I would say between probably like Serbia. I'm talking about not that I played. You're talking about like overall in Europe, right? You know, Serbian fans are really crazy.
Turkey and
Turkey and Greece. You know, they get really.
The team that you played.
Oh, the team that I played. Okay. I think Murcia has a great fan base.
Okay.
Yeah.
2016, 2018. Back again. We started to talk about Stelmet Zielonogora.
Yeah.
What you can tell about this club? Teammates, everything I will ask.
Well, yeah, you know, again, when I told you before I came to Zielonogora, I called Sasho and I called Koszarek because for me, Lukasz Koszarek was, I wanted to play with him because I knew that if I come, he's the type of point guard that I really respect. And I played with him in Turov and I knew him and the national team. And he's the guy you want to play with. He's the right guy for this team. So, and he told me honest, he was honest with me and he told me about some of the problems, some of the good things, some of the bad things. But at the end, I came to Zielonogora because of Koszarek was going to be someone there that I knew and that I trusted. And then they just came off winning a championship. They're one of the better teams, and I want to be part of something like that. So that's why I made that decision.
I remember, because that was your first season in Zielona Góra, we played each other in the semifinals. It was 2-2.
Yeah. That was
fifth game is always, you know, that's a lottery. Well, it was close still. I don't know.
I think that because it was on our home court.
Yes.
That's what saved us, I think, because you guys were tough.
We tried to. I was thinking if we beat Torun in the in a final.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
We talk about you. How you remember those playoffs?
Intense, man. Playoffs, that's the beauty. The biggest beauty of sport for me is in those moments, at the end of the year, in the playoffs. For fans too, I'm sure everyone comes there. You forget all your little, you know, little things like I'm scoring, all your statistics. You just try to do everything you can for the team. You sacrifice to win, and you come together. That's when teams that really come together, that play with each other, they're usually the ones that you know, go on to finish and win a championship. So I love that moment.
But you can admit to play in Zielona Góra in CRS Arena, and those fans are, it's great.
Where?
In Zielona Góra.
In the
arena.
They're great. They're great. And they're, what I like about Zielona Góra is even, I mean, when I was there, we went through some difficult times the second year, but I feel like they were still with us. They had the patience, you know, like sometimes we weren't playing the best. You know, like any fan, they want you to come and give you 100%. They don't expect you to come and win everything, but they expect you to, you know, to play hard. And if you do that, they'll cheer you on. They'll support you.
I remember it's great to
play good atmosphere
for them. And I have to ask you about Coach Gronek.
Yeah, Artur.
Because that season gave him a lot. He handled the pressure.
I think he's great. I really enjoyed it. I mean, listen, there's so many things probably going through his head because of, like I told you, that noise that he had to deal with. People were always
young
constantly,
he's young,
he's not this. And you know, I've never seen anyone who really, I mean, he really understood his situation. And he did one of the smartest things, I think, is he didn't come in and just do it my way. I'm going to do it my way. He listened to his veteran players, to Košarek, to me.
Smart.
He talked. Yeah, he leaned on us, which I don't think a lot of young coaches would have done. They would have tried to show something. And
I'm the best, yes.
Yeah, so for Artur, I think he's done a good job. I think he's going to be a good coach. And I don't think people realize he works harder than anybody.
I remember everything.
Yeah, he's got like almost obsession about basketball and wanting to do it the right way.
I
which
think
is good.
He, even if he's first coach, he's still making scouting by himself.
The details. The details.
Everything he's doing, and he's doing right now. Good job in Bydgoszcz.
I say I'm happy for
and
him.
And before that, in Polpharma.
Yeah.
I have so many things here. I don't want to.
No, don't worry.
Wait. Coach, you tell me about Coach Gronek. Yes, and after that, after I don't know, 2 months, 3 months, he was fired next season.
Yeah.
And I have to ask you about Coach Urlep, because jak się mówi, in the 90s, to wiem, 90 lata, a 2000s.
Yeah.
He was, you know, famous coach, very good coach, and he won a lot. He was respected. That's what I can tell about him.
Yeah.
Tell me about
Urlep.
Coach Urlep.
I can.
And after that, I'm always asking guests from he was Dyskowski was here, Wączyński from Anvil. I'm always asking about this fifth game. What happened? You could see from the.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
From you were sitting on a bench, yes.
That from the Anvil. Yeah,
fifth game
in Anvil. Oh yeah, yeah. Well, first of all, Urlep, man. So I was a little nervous when he came in, because I was like, man, I heard again all the rumors.
You remember playoffs against Turów Śląsk?
Śląsk, yeah, yeah. So I heard that, and I said, man, you know, I was always worried, like, he's going to be another Balkan coach where he's going to kill me in practice and stuff like that. And, you know, we worked hard, but hey, when he got there, he was, I mean, the experience and how intelligent he was. He just came in and he just was calm. And he said, okay, these are the things that I think we need to change. He grabbed me on the side. You know, it's funny because I think he thought I was, maybe he's been hearing that I was old or something. I don't know what he thought of me, but after the first week, he kind of grabs me. He's like, I didn't know. He's like, I didn't know you could still play like that.
No.
So yeah, really, he told me. And then, you know, I was like laughing. I was like, yeah, coach, I can play, you know? So, and we went on, we had a good relationship.
Because last time he saw you 10 years.
So it was funny, but we had a good relationship. You know, we talked a lot and, you know, I played well under him. So,
worst question for a basketball player is what happened, why you lost the game, but tell me what you can say about this fifth game, because that was important.
Yeah,
you could win the championship.
So I think the crucial moment was when of that game, first of all, and Wrocławek, those fans are, you can't hear yourself think. Yes. I was just at a game just this year with Ignierski, and Iggy's sitting right here in the fans, and I couldn't talk to him because of how loud it was. So that's one thing. But we had controlled the game. We've done well. Anvil was out. And then James Florence at one point, no, it was something before that. I think James Florence got into foul trouble. Something happened where the change of the pace, which is normal in basketball, you know, the teams make runs. But when James Florence fouled out, we didn't have another ball handler. I was usually a guy on the team that would handle
bring the ball up.
So nobody was there to help Košarić, really. And it's tough in those moments because you know, the momentum is on Anvil. You can't hear anything. You know, it's just,
that was incredible.
How everything, it just shows you how fragile the game of basketball can be. When you can be sitting here on top and in a few seconds, in a few minutes, everything that could go wrong just happens. And it was just enough for them. And
I remember I sent a message to Zamo with congratulations that you are in the final 3 minutes before the game. And I, after that, I didn't know what to tell him again.
Yeah.
So you couldn't believe what's going on.
And the hardest thing is to watch it in front of you and know you can't do anything. This, I felt so helpless because I was injured. And I promise you, I still to this day, I told James Florence, I said, if I was healthy, if I didn't get injured, Zlatogora would have won a championship that year.
For sure. I'm pretty sure.
I started to play really well at the end and we were playing good. So
your hand was injured or?
No, my knee.
Knee.
My
knee.
Against Ostrofa.
Okay. My knee. So, Thomas, 2019, you signed again with Zlatogora because you signed 2 year deal.
No,
I
signed a 2 year deal from 2016-17 and 17-18. And then I was in good, you know, communication with him. So I wanted to play and this is one thing I can say about him. He was like, he talked with me the whole time.
Yes, tell me about him.
He was like, hey, you know, there's always a, we'll wait for you. There's a door here. There's a, you know, you can come here and finish your career here. And it's one thing I have respect for him for that, because he allowed me to go through what I was going, you know, with not just the injury, but, there was some family issues in the US mm-hmm. that I had to take care of. That's why I didn't play that year. And then, you know, we sat down when it was time to sign and he was like, I was like, hey, he's like, can you be ready to play? I said, yeah, I think I can be ready. And he really took it upon himself. He said, because we got into it and he said, you know, the risk is on me. He said, I take you. If it doesn't work out, I take the blame. It's nothing on you. I don't want you to feel bad about it. So we ended up signing for that last 2 months.
We most important question right now, I think, for you and for the fans. We spoke about this before we started to with Mr. Adam to record this. You still want to play basketball? It's not over.
No. No, I still want to.
Tell more.
Well, the last.
If you sign right now, 5% for me, okay?
Okay. It's on record. It's on record.
3 for Mr. Adam.
Yeah. Well, yeah. 4. So, okay. We'll see. You know, because last thing anyone's ever heard from me in basketball court was that injury install, and people think that I didn't play because of my knee, but it's, you know, like I said, my father was ill with cancer, and so I took a year off. And
sorry.
I shouldn't have played last year. Thank you, because my head wasn't into it. I didn't. So now he passed away in May. I've kind of gathered myself, and I think that I'm going to make sure that I'm prepared properly. That's why I kind of got injured again with my ankle last time in Zlatogora. But now I'll take the proper training and create a, you know, get into good training form and then try to play maybe the last 3 months of this season. If anybody wants me, I don't know if anybody
so,
wants
so
me,
next so. Season you're ready to go
this
for
season,
sure
this season
still
yeah, this
oh
season. Yeah, yeah this season it's a
good player to sign really
well like I told my wife, I said, hey, you know, like I'll give myself, I've already started training.
Hey, maybe Anvil they are looking for
I don't know. I said March 1st okay. 1st I should be ready.
Okay,
so
great.
Yeah,
super. You watch Polish league right now?
A little bit. Yeah.
I'm making always taki typer polski, Polish. Jak to się mówi? Jak to powie? Type? Nie typer. Panie kibice, you say from first place till late after with medals
oof,
predictions.
Oof,
yes.
Oof, man.
Well, maybe 4.
Maybe we'll start with 4. Okay. So Zlatogora is gonna be, should be. I can't say is.
first?
Well, no, I don't know. I'm going to say four because yeah, well, top four teams, then we'll Jean-Longo right now is the favorite. Let's say they're playing really good. The coach has got them playing incredible on defense. They're intense. Anvil is always going to be dangerous because they got talent and they got a good coach.
If they sign you, they are first.
Yeah.
Dobra.
But again, going back to that, I think with Anvil, these Americans need to realize that they need to lean on each other, you know, lean on your team. And you can get there. Use the guys around you to take
care. I said
it, so.
You are in Anvil because you know that Tony Rotten was waived. He moved to
he went to Hoven too, Spain. Yeah.
Yes, to Badalona.
Well, you never know. But
I have to work for my 5%. You know. And third place.
Well, okay. I'm not going in special order, but one of the, I think the teams will be in the final four. Let's say I think Toron.
Toron. Dobra. And the last fourth.
And the fourth. Honestly, I haven't looked at the standings. I only know those three teams, but well,
tak Gdynia, po polsku powiem strzelaj, shoot.
Gdynia, no. Is Gdynia pretty good? Arka. Yes. Arka's pretty good.
Dobra. Masz batona sobie od Marcina, you can choose. Marcin Gortat was
nice.
2 hours before you, so
okay.
Zostawię mi trochę batonów. Perfect. Let's schowajmy
Mr.
to.
Mr. Gortat. What's he doing? I heard he's doing something with kids.
He has some questions for you, yes.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Hey. If you will join him.
For sure.
Summer.
Oh, where? To where? In
to
Poland?
To help him.
If I'm in Poland, I mean, working with kids is something that I would love to do.
A może założy? Możesz założyć koszulkę? Put it on this. I'm Jordan, you
I can't take off my shirt because I'm still got about 10 kilos.
Don't worry about that. I don't want it.
No, don't worry.
Just put it on this. How is my English? It's great.
Yeah, yeah.
I was so scared, you know. Mr. Adam, it's okay?
It's okay.
And just 2 years in high school. And
what am I going to say when my kids, you know, they're very...
Don't
they're
translate
gonna ask,
that.
They're going to say, Dad, what is that? What is
don't
that?
Translate. Just say that's Jordan.
They'll figure out, they're pretty smart.
Nie, ale okay. Powiem wam wszystkim szczerze, że kurde, strasznie się denerwowałem tym angielskim, ale powinien mieć to w pompie. Taki polski i angielski i tak dalej. Coś dogadaliśmy się z Tomkiem.
Dobra. I'm Jordan.
Jordan, you pussy.
Oh, yeah, tak, okay.
5 prawą ręką, 5 lewą, and last 3 shots I will try to disturb you a little bit.
You can move the mic.
Tak, przesuwamy mikrofon.
Okay, what's the record?
No, I guess Zamój.
Zamój is there.
No, I should, because I made the interview with myself, you know. I made
can I take that practice shot to see what...
Yes, I can give you one.
Should I...
Use the tapchan. I call this tapchan.
Use it? Yeah.
Yeah, glass. I mean, that's okay, not glass, but...
Are we starting? Or
yeah. Start. Jedziemy. Aha. Oh, yeah. Jeden.
Oh, this is gonna be easy.
Yeah? 3-3. Idzie na rekord.
No!
Widzisz? 3.
Dobra.
Lewa. Nie. No, teraz no. Lewa.
Left hand.
He got it. He still got it. Thomas Kelati from downtown. Oh my god, what a shot by Thomas Kelati.
Nie wierzę. This is...
Jest.
Okay.
Ile? 3. Dzięki panie. Wait.
Oh man.
Historii tego swetra i tak nie znasz. I will try to be a little bit funny, I always do
okay,
that.
Okay.
Oh, my nose, kurde, fell down. She fell off. Wait.
Oh, wow.
Widziałeś, Tomek? Jeszcze nie rzucaj, wait.
Czekam.
Mr. Adam, he's destroyed right now. Hey, without nose, I have big nose on you. O, dobra, tak. Rzucaj, Tomek, rzucaj.
Dobra.
Rzucaj.
Mogę prawa?
Możesz prawa, lewu. Uważaj, rzucaj. Yes, ma. Mój nos. Jak Michael Jackson, łap, nos. O Boże. Nosem, uważaj, nosem. He
got it.
Dobra, 3-3.
3-3.
Yeah, better with
that's you. How I play better under pressure.
I got mustachio in my in my face. To jest to.
Mike's.
Oh, yeah. You see, I'm stupid, kurde. Dobra, Tomek, questions from fans.
Okay.
From Twitter and Instagram. Some of them might be rumors.
Okay.
Dobra, zaczynamy. What was the role you were supposed to take in Stelmet?
It's a good question. I think my role, it was never defined. You know, when I got there, I spoke with Marta Gronek, you know, my first year. Yeah.
Thomas, I'm thinking about maybe I understood different after if you don't play basketball.
Ah, okay. If I don't play. Oh, yeah. Right now, I just want to. Me and my family, we're talking about moving there to Zelenogora because we want to be around that city. We like it and the basketball. And then I would hope to have some kind of involvement, you know, with the club or even with the youth program.
Okay.
Work with young players.
So that's a good rumor. Mm. David Wojtycki is asking, what did you think about fall of Turów?
It's tragic, man. You know, the Turów, if you think about Zgorzelec, it's always been associated with that, with Zgorzelec. So that team and the people there are really, you know, it's been around for so long. There's a lot of history and the fans. When I talk to people there, even there, they're saddened by it. You know, the team's not there anymore. So I think they need to do something to bring the team back.
Next question, the same guy he is asking: was there a time in your career with Polish national team when you felt uncomfortable?
No, I felt ashamed, you know, when we didn't achieve, you know, what we were supposed to, but never uncomfortable.
Okay. Przemysław XYZ dwa pytania ma. Your first impression when you saw Kobe, you answered, but you can say it shortly, when you saw Kobe in the gym.
It's like anybody seeing like a meeting there, let's say they're not a superhero, but they're idol. You know, he's somebody I really respect and looked up to. So when I first saw him, it was surreal. I couldn't believe it. You know, it was exciting for me.
The same guy asking top five Lakers players in 21st century.
Oh man. Does that 21st century. So that includes, that's tough, man. well, does LeBron and Anthony Davis count because they're playing with the team?
Yes.
LeBron, Anthony Davis. Kobe's always, you know, obviously.
Shaq.
And Laker. I don't know. I really respected.
I understand.
Okay. I don't know.
Is there something extreme that you picked up from Kobe work ethic?
I picked up a few, let's say, tricks to do on the court, you know, some few things. So grabbing the back of the leg when you're going around the pick and roll, you know.
Especially you can use Hrycaniuk, perfect skills.
Yes, grabbing, you know, the
but
the,
I'm sorry that I przeszkadzam ci. You using a leg of your teammate or
no? I actually he grabbed the defender's leg.
The defender.
It's illegal. You can't do it, but he does it really well. I don't know how when he rips the ball. I couldn't move my leg, and he's done that to me before. So
that
trying that, and also my trick that I learned from him also is so a lot of times when you drive past a player, they hand check you. It's naturally they put their hand on you. If you slap their hand off, it throws them off balance, and just enough for you to get by. A lot of players actually in Poland were complaining about it with me. I shouldn't say that because I still want to play. But I mean, it's not. I mean, listen, if their hand is on me, I get it off. So
and immediately I go
by and somehow I'll grab their hand that's on me and I'll throw it off, and that is enough to allow me to get by them because it knocks them off balance.
Kobe got tricks.
Yeah.
fans from Zielona Góra asking about overdue payments.
It's a work in progress, let's say. You know, I'm in communication with the team, and I hope that, you know, they're going to follow through what they've said. We have a planned date. You know, I don't want to blame, I don't know what the whole situation is there, but I don't think it's just that their fault. You know, I think that there's some things going around, maybe some sponsorship that is delayed, and I'm hoping that those will be taken care of soon.
Jakub Kucharski, memories from Belgium playing with Igor Milicic. You said. Terrible.
Yeah. No, well, with Igor, playing with Igor was great. I mean, I was only terrible with the coach. But you know, Igor was an incredible point guard. Very smart. That's, you can see that's why he's such a good coach.
Yes, I agree. So. Jakub Jaworski, how do you rate working with Coach Jovovich?
You know, I didn't get to really work with him too much. They were always traveling in VTB, and I was not part of the team, so I was with the assistant coaches working. So not much time there.
I think same guy asking, what do you think about Kobe? You asked, answered me, but about Kobe Bryant, I will not ask you again this question. Dave 14, Kapitan, asking, are you going to play in Alcatraz streetball in Wałbrzych? I don't know what.
Actually, you know? Yeah. Yes? I told him I would this summer. You know what? My wife is pregnant, so we're having our fourth child. So. We'll see. I have to see the dates, and my family's coming from US, but I want to. I played last year. It was great.
Tak?
Yeah. Street ball, baby. That's,
maybe we can.
I mean, I played with.
With who?
Oh my gosh. He's gonna kill me now. Kuba, the assistant coach on Zielonogora. Lewandowski.
Okay.
He got me. I played with him on his team.
Dobra, I want to play with you.
Let's do it.
Me, you, streaks and yeah. Post up.
Yep. I'm down.
Mulan asking. Czekaj. Ah, business or basketball? Which direction?
Oof. Together. Razem.
Czekaj. Razem. You can answer in Polish. You want to try?
Not really. Yeah. If I can, I will.
Czekaj, bo ja już tu mam tyle tu napisałem, że... Dobra. Bartosz Tytman. Toughest decision you had to make in your career?
Oh, good question. Toughest decision.
Panie Adamie, masz pan okulary sobie, weź.
I think it's, let's say not the one decision, but one of the decisions that I've had to make in my career numerous times is I've had to sacrifice my own individual playing and statistics because I thought that, you know, it's better for the team. And that's always been a tough decision because, you know, and unfortunately the guy who plays well and has statistics gets paid. And a lot of times we play with players that, you know, they wouldn't be able to do it. So I sacrificed, even in Zielonogora, I couldn't do what I wanted to do, let's say play, because it had to be for the better of the team.
Okay, your favorite food?
Favorite food? My wife asked me that question too. Like, if I could only have one food in the world, it would be French fries.
Oh, frytki. Tom ten, nickname. Lakers or Clippers?
Oh, right now?
Yes, right now. Short answer.
Oh, man. Clippers.
Okay. What kind of person was Ron Artest?
Unbelievable. The funniest. I was scared of him, actually, because I've heard also, you know, probably what this guy's thinking. Great guy. Probably he was the one that talked to me the most, probably.
Yes?
Over there, yeah. It's like random things, but great dude. Great guy.
Okay. Thank you for saying that.
Yeah.
Anna from Wrocławek asking, have you ever received offer from Anvil? Maybe after this podcast.
Like unofficially, I've spoke with Igor a couple of times and we're thinking about going there. But it's kind of far from Zgorzelec and you know, with me, it's all about my kids. And at that time they were studying in English. So I had to choose a city that there was English schools, international schools. Mm-hmm.
Dobra, Gringo Pelka, what surprised you the most about working with Andre Urlep? And that's a question. And what was the outcome of the visit with biotherapist? I've heard about that.
Who asked me that question?
Gringo Pelka. Gringo PLK. I swear to God,
I think that I
always we can cut this. Yeah,
no. Well, I with Urlep, I think I created this image in my head that he was going to come in and be so tough and so difficult and kill me. But he was actually very understanding, and he was actually someone you could speak with about basketball. And so that was probably the biggest surprise. And then the I'm still waiting on the treatment from the.
Oh, you're still waiting. Okay.
Yeah, I still haven't received it yet.
The Vitis 85. Sing Disco Polo. You know Disco Polo?
Sing it?
Disco Polo.
You sing Disco
Polo? You know Disco Polo? This type of the music?
I don't know.
No, dobra.
Boli mi głowa. No. Nie mogę. I don't know. This is my Polish. This is my, you know?
Nie mogę spać.
Yeah.
A ten, kto to śpiewa? Boli mi głowa i nie mogę spać.
But I
tylko noc, tak?
Yeah. But
obsrany kot.
Well, because you know I have my adaptation was no. Boli mi noga, nie mogę grać. You know, this is, and I was singing that and...
O kurde, pan Adam will make a mixtape out of that. Boli mnie noga i nie mogę grać. Dobra, Tomek, your favorite shoes?
Easy. The Damian Lillard number... Was it three? Damian Lillard
Wklejesz three. Wklejesz te Lillardy trójki? Muszę go prosić. What color?
Nie
mam pojęcia. Favorite music?
Depends on the mood. Okay. I listen to everything.
Movie?
Shawshank Redemption.
Okay. And jak się seriale mój? TV show?
Yeah, TV series. Game of Thrones.
Okay, I like that too. You watch Polish TV shows? Klan na przykład albo...
Well, I try. I need to start.
A żona co ogląda TV show?
What do you call this?
Polish.
Yeah, it's Polish one. No. This is, I don't know, they're in...
Try. Figure out.
I think it takes place in Warsaw or Wrocław.
Na wspólnej.
Na wspólnej.
No, widziałeś, no. I Tomek też musi na wspólnej oglądać. Dobra, jedziemy dalej.
I szpital.
I oglądasz szpital.
I ukryta prawda. Hey, say this.
Yes, ukryta prawda.
Ukryta prawda.
So many emotions, you know, there. My son likes drogówka.
Hey, you know what's funny? I see my
yes,
what's
his Zgorzelca.
Nie, ten...
Nie, kto?
Krieger.
No, Krieger ze Zgorzelca.
I saw him on TV, I was, wow.
He is always, I think, our policeman or gangster.
Yeah.
That's funny. That's good that you said about this. what do you think about Milan Gurovic, Mr. Maka 3? Ask.
I think Gurovic should have fought me one-on-one.
Okay.
No.
And they finished in this way. Best Polish player you played with and against?
Best Polish player played with.
Oof. Yeah, if you say one, others will be mad. Probably.
No, yes. I played the longest with. I really have a big respect for Koszarek.
Koszarek.
Yeah.
And against?
Played against.
Polish.
Pluto was tough.
Andrzej
Pluto was tough in Anvil.
Old school basketball.
Yeah.
Pestro 23. Did you ever have mental toughness coach?
No, I don't need that.
Dobra.
My dad.
Okay. Do you Profanum 1988? Do you see yourself as a coach?
Maybe. Still.
Dobra.
Thinking about that.
You have papers to that? Ja nie wiem, jak to jest.
No, because I mean, I know it. I'd have to go through the process. Yes. I don't have it.
Okay. Lewy answer, that's his nickname. Things that you could change in your career would be?
Oh. I wouldn't have been... Okay, so there's this thing that when I was in San Antonio Spurs, the coach told me, it's a true story, he came up to me and he said, Thomas, you are a hell of a player, but you're too nice for the NBA. So my dad used to say the same thing, like, you know, and people have told me, oh, you're too unselfish. So I guess
this,
maybe that if I wanted to play in the NBA, but at the same time, I'm very happy and I have no regrets about how my career is.
That's kind of person
that's who I am, you know, so
you have to change.
Yeah. So, I mean,
to be rude or something, I don't know. Kraft 04 asking, what taught you NBA?
NBA?
No, that's correct. I go, thank you, Mr. Adam.
Yeah, the NBA taught me how not to play basketball.
Oh.
How not to play basketball. Yeah. I can't watch the NBA.
Really?
I don't like it. I prefer watching good
Euro. The NBA, modern NBA or?
No, modern NBA.
Okay.
Of the past? Okay, I grew up, that's different.
Dobra.
Detroit Bad Boys, the Pistons.
Oof. Detroit.
Mm. They were fun to watch back then.
Grabowski Roland, would you play 3-on-3 streetball? You answered that.
Yeah.
Stolar 89. Most important game in your career.
Most important game in my career. Lotomatica Roma. EuroLeague, Malaga. It was actually the best game. I found out my mom had been diagnosed with a disease, and that was the next game that I played after that, and had an incredible game.
Wojtikue, why you didn't play for Poznań, Pierwsza Liga? Because they saw you, probably.
Well, I never really got an official offer from them, and also there was, I don't know, I didn't really, okay. You know.
Kubavu, great, he's saying, great career in many clubs, best player you played with?
Best player I played with? I like my point guard, so I really respect Omar Cook. He was, as far as seeing the game and all that, one of the best players I've played with.
Mateusz Jejda, jeśli dobrze przeczytałem. If not basketball, what other sport you will choose?
Baseball.
Baseball.
I played American baseball, yeah.
You playing with your kids sometimes? Try?
Yeah, well, Europe, it's not so big. We play football, soccer.
And last question from Marcin Gortat, because he's always asking questions. Are you planning to join Marcin, him and his foundation on his camps? And help working with kids. Dobrze, panie Adamie, przeczytałem? Super.
I'm definitely looking forward to talking more about it, and if I'm in Poland, why not?
Tomek, dziękuję ci bardzo. Po polsku coś chcesz jeszcze powiedzieć, czy nie?
Nie jestem gotowy.
Tak. To była dla mnie duża przyjemność, duży stres, tak jak powiedziałem, was stress for me. I tried as best as I can to
talk. You did good. And most people speak better English than I speak Polish, so it's better for...
Dziękuję ci bardzo. I wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Zdrowia
Thank
i szczęścia so przede wszystkim.
Dziękuję
bardzo za przybycie.
Wspieramy naszych sportowców. Polskie zakłady bukmacherskie PZ Book.